Hello guys, can you imagine a tree for which police protection is given throughout the year? A tree which has nearly 2500 years of history? A tree for which a special agricultural officer has been appointed to check its health every week? A tree for which close to 15 lakh rupees is being spent every year for its maintenance? Yes, in this video we are going to look at such a tree. Such a tree exists in India, in the state of Madhya Pradesh. It is located exactly between Bhopal and Vidisha, and somewhere like 5 kilometers away from the famous UNESCO World Heritage Site called Sanchi. Yes, by this time many people would have guessed why the tree is so special. It is related to the famous religion Buddhism. The tree is known as Bodhi Vriksha, and it was planted by former Sri Lankan President and current Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa in 2012. It was planted on a hilltop in a place called Salmathpur. This hill and close to 100 acres around this hill was decided to be developed into a world famous Buddhist university known as Sanchi University of Buddhist Indic Studies. In order to commemorate the opening of that university, Sri Lanka, which is a Buddhist country, had sent its president and along with him the Bodhi tree, a sapling of the Bodhi tree, to be planted in such a place where a world famous Buddhist university is supposed to come up. In order to know why this Bodhi tree is so famous in Buddhism, we should look at the life of Buddha. Buddha was born in a royal family. He was a prince. He was supposed to be the next king. But looking at the sufferings of the people around him and the sufferings of the people in his country, Buddha wanted to know what was the reason for the suffering and how it could be removed from the lives of the people. So, in order to search for this truth, he left his palace and then he was wandering in the countryside and meditating to know what is the reason and how it could be solved. It is said that Buddha sat under a Bodhi tree and meditated for many days to finally know the truth. That is why this Bodhi tree has got a lot of significance in Buddhism. This Bodhi tree actually is in a place called Bodh Gaya in the state of Bihar in India. Buddha attained enlightenment nearly 531 years before the birth of Christ. In the 3rd century BCE, Emperor Ashoka, who was very powerful at that time and a very staunch Buddhist devotee, wanted to spread Buddhism throughout the world. So he sent his missionaries to all parts of the world. Thus he also sent his son and daughter to Sri Lanka to spread Buddhism. Along with them he had sent a small branch of the original Bodhi tree, which is in Bodh Gaya, to be planted somewhere in Sri Lanka. So his son and daughter planted this small part of the original Bodhi tree in a place called Anuradhapura in Sri Lanka. From that day to till this day, that tree is still alive in Sri Lanka and is being very safely guarded. And in fact, that tree is also been recorded as the oldest living tree planted by a human, which is now nearly 2300 years old or more. So Rajapaksa, who was invited for the opening of this world famous Buddhist university, brought a small sapling of the tree from Anuradhapura and planted it here in India as a mark of respect for Buddhism and also for this great international university that is supposed to be run from this place. Now many of you can ask, like, when the original Bodhi tree is already present in Bodh Gaya in India, why should this sapling, which is a descendant of the tree which is in Anuradhapura, has to be brought here? Why can't we bring the sapling from the original Bodhi tree? To tell you the truth, the original Bodhi tree does not exist anymore and it was destroyed. Actually, the destruction of this tree dates back to many years and many attempts have been done. The very first recorded attempt of destroying the Bodhi tree was done by the last wife of Emperor Ashoka himself. The irony is that Ashoka was a very staunch Buddhist and he wanted to spread Buddhism throughout the world. But his last wife did not like Buddhism or the Bodhi tree and she wanted to destroy it, and an attempt was made to destroy the tree. But it is said that magically a new tree started growing from the very same place where the original tree was destroyed. Later, a king called Pushyamitra Sunga, he also destroyed the tree, but again it is said that magically a new tree started to grow from the same place where it was destroyed. Then another 500 to 600 years later, another king also tried to destroy the tree, but again the same thing happened. Magically a new tree started growing from the very same place. These three have been the very important recorded history of destruction of the original Bodhi tree. Then later, somewhere in 1876, it is said that the original Bodhi tree was uprooted or completely destroyed due to a very big storm. That is the recorded history of the original Bodhi tree by the British historians at that particular point of time. So, the British archaeologist named Alexander Cunningham, he wanted to do something to that place where the tree was no more. So he went to Sri Lanka, to the place Anuradhapura, where the descendant of the original Bodhi tree was planted by Ashoka's daughter and son, which was almost more than 2000 years old now. So from there he took a cutting, he made a sapling out of it, and he brought that and planted it in the very same place of the original Bodhi tree in Bodh Gaya in Bihar. So that tree, which was planted somewhere 4 to 5 years later after the destruction of the tree, is what stays there till now. The tree that is being worshipped now is not the original tree that dates back to the time of Buddha, but something that was planted by the British archaeologist Alexander Cunningham in the very same place where Buddha attained enlightenment. Because of this history, the tree that was planted in the Buddhist university assumes a great significance, it being the direct descendant of the Anuradhapura Bodhi tree, which in turn is the direct descendant of the Bodhi tree under which Buddha attained enlightenment. That is why this tree, which is being grown in the university campus, assumes great importance and is being protected with great care. Thank you. If you found this video to be helpful, informative and interesting, please do consider subscribing to this channel and giving a like to this video. This will help us and motivate us to bring more such good informative videos to you. Thank you.